Welcome to SMB Stories MSME Week. Presented by Google and powered by Dell Small Business, SMB Stories MSME Week is a week-long celebration of India's best homegrown brands. And today, we have with us Stephen Pinto, who's the founder of one of Bengaluru's most well-loved seafood restaurants, Mangalore Pearl. Welcome to the show, Stephen.
Thank you, Richard.
So first things off, Stephen actually started Mangalore Pearl in 2004. Before this, he was working in an IT company. But then he discovered his love for seafood and decided to quit his job to start a business instead. So Stephen, why don't you tell us a little bit about what inspired you to start your own business and how you discovered your love for seafood?
Actually, from my childhood itself, I was passionate about cooking. And once I started working, you know, the main thing for me unwinding in the evening was to get some, prepare some dishes at home. And mostly I was brought up in a seafood environment, so that was my main area. And I wanted seafood desperately, and this was something that was lacking wherever I worked. And I thought, you know, this is the best way to, you know, get into my passion continuing.
Yeah. Right. So was it something that you used to be passionate about at the end of the day when you, you know, came back from work and you felt like cooking some seafood just to, you know, release some of that stress?
It's not only seafood, it's any kind of dishes that I was interested in. It's just that, going out to the restaurant and eating was something that, you know, quite expensive and all those things. And this was something that was keeping me occupied. So that is why, you know, I discovered that my love for seafood, love for food basically was the first priority. Then, you know, the job was okay. And I found that, okay, this was my second calling. So basically, this is how it all started.
Right. Speaking of second calling, you were 40 years old when you decided to leave your job and start Mangalore Pearl. So tell me about that.
Starting any business, you need to have a good, financial base. And unless you have that, it's a bit riskier thing. So I wanted to be very, sure about the financial, the losses or whatever that are going to be incurred. And I wanted to see myself that, wanted to see and discover that, you know, at least for the first year, the financial thing that I have, at least if there are losses, I could, you know, support myself without buying or without taking any loans from outside. So that is the reason I started at a late age of 40.
Yeah. So you started Mangalore Pearl in Fraser Town, right? So can you tell me how you went from leaving your job to actually setting up a business?
Actually, the place that I started, it was already known as Konkan before. I mean, there was already a running restaurant.
Okay.
And it was a seafood restaurant also in Fraser Town. And I knew the owner of that restaurant who himself was a qualified chartered accountant. And he ran the business for about 3-4 years and he wanted to give it up. Then he saw that passion in me and he asked me if I want to take over. Take over as in to... He wanted to sell basically the whole outlet and sell as in to take up the rented premises. And I showed interest and I took it over from him along with the staff as in and renovated the place and then started and changed the name to Mangalore Pearl. So this is how the journey started.
Right.
Yeah.
So whenever businesses start, it's very crucial to get that product market fit. Right. So when you started your business, you identified a sort of Mangalore Catholic kind of cuisine which you wanted to actually bring to Bengaluru, and you had actually seen that there was a gap in the market, right?
Yes.
So tell us how you identified that gap and how you aim to, you know, bridge the gap.
There are quite a few Mangalorean restaurants in Bangalore or all over India. But when you come to Mangalorean restaurant, there are three kind of communities that are very popular there. One is Catholic community, one is Bunds community, and one is Konkani speaking community, Konkans. These people have three different kind of cuisines actually. I was finding that, you know, most of these restaurants the Mangalorean restaurants were mainly run by you know, the Shettis and Bunds, where you find only the dishes that are very famously available in the Bunds community. Whereas, you know, a Catholic community was totally missing in Bangalore. So I capitalized that. I thought that, okay, we have got 4 or 5 flavors of fish curries, which were really missing in any of these restaurants. So I felt that, okay, bringing out a Mangalorean restaurant would really add value. And there is a lot of Mangalorean Catholic community here in Bangalore. And Fraser Town is one strong area where there is a, and luckily, you know, the the premises that were, you know, that was available also happens to be in Fraser Town. So it was kind of luck for me that, you know, both happened at the same time. So that is what the, you know, that is how I thought of giving Mangalorean recipes to.
Right. And Stephen, from day one, since you launched the restaurant, you have been going to Russell Market every day morning at 5:15 a.m. to procure the freshest fish that is on offer. And you still do it to this day, 15 years later.
Yes.
Tell us how that benefits you.
The main benefit is that, see, when it comes to fish, there is every chance that if you leave that option to the vendor, you will not get 100% fresh fish. Number one. Number two, when you go to the market, there are about, you know, more than 25 varieties of seafood that is available anytime in the market. So only when you go from one end to one shop to another shop, you will know that this fish is, you know, if I only speak to him and over the phone, vendor will not know whether this fish will be, I'll be interested or not. Only when I go to the market and then when I see the fish, that I know that this fish is, there are takers, going to be takers. So that is why, you know, I have to go to the market. I can't leave it to the vendors to supply the fish to me directly.
Right. So personally, you know, that personal touch is required when you're actually selecting the fresh fish, right?
Yeah.
And when you do work with vendors, or at least other restaurants who work with vendors, the vendors charge them maybe around 20 to 30% more
yeah.
on the fish. So you are actually saving that much amount on the fish.
Yeah.
And you are able to pass that benefit on to the user in the sense that the pricing for your dishes is a bit lesser. So tell us a little bit about your pricing strategy. What kind of customers are you trying to target with that slightly, you know, more affordable seafood dishes?
See, the thing is this, today seafood restaurants, the moment people, customer think about seafood restaurants, the one thing that goes to their mind is prices are exorbitantly high in a restaurant. That's mainly because, you know, these restaurants who are running seafood restaurants, basically they call the vendors and they ask them to supply the fish. They do not know the day's pricing actually. But when I go to the market, I know exactly what the price is for that particular day. And this is a wholesale price that they get, that they give it to me for. And when it's a wholesale price, there is at least a difference of 20 to 30%. Now, if you consider, you go to the market and you see in a supermarket, the difference is huge. A mackerel which is costing 200 rupees a kilo in Russell Market is costing about 300 rupees when you buy from the supermarket. Imagine 100 rupees on a per kilo, which I can pass it on, pass this benefit to the customer. I will definitely have repeated customers coming back to me.
Yeah.
So that's the main point. So this is where I save on. So this is where I pass on the benefit to the customer, and I save on all this, you know, the on the raw material.
Right. So you have two benefits. One is the fact that your cuisine tastes authentic,
right.
And the other is the affordable prices.
Yeah.
So using this strategy, the brand has grown quite a lot in the past 15 years.
Right.
So much so that you have opened a new outlet in Alsur.
Right.
So you have two outlets. So tell us, what is the kind of revenue that, you know, Mangalore Pearl makes per year?
The thing is that, see, we have two outlets put together. On an average, we get about 25 lakhs to 28 lakhs is our revenue actually per month.
Per month.
Per month.
Okay.
And considering we are closed on Tuesdays, the least of the business is on Mondays. Okay. And we are closed on Tuesdays. So you take out, say, for example, 4 days out of a 30-day month, and you can say 1 lakh on an average, 1 lakh a day is the revenue for both the outlets put together.
So it adds up to around 3 crores per year.
It adds up to about 3 to 3.5 crores. Yeah.
Okay. And how many employees do you have to, you know, keep these two outlets running?
You need at least, and I have 38 members, actually, you need at least 2 or 3 more if you have the hands are free, kind of say,
mm-hmm.
I would say. But you need 40 mainly because, you know, the business, is the crowd comes only on a Saturday and Sunday, and during that time, you need a lot of staff. So only to serve on a Saturday and Sunday, we need to have 40 members. At the moment, we have 38 members actually, 36 to 37, 38 members. So,
mm-hmm.
So we have a staff strength about 38 right now.
So not just to do with the workforce, but there are a lot of other challenges that food businesses face, right from capital to keeping the business running, day-to-day operations. So tell us a little bit about some of the challenges that you have faced along the way.
I started on a very low, very, you know, what word is used, free, some, anyway, I mean, it was a simple restaurant when I started, It had a basic, furniture, and we had only about 10 staff during that time, only 4 in the waiting area and 4 in the kitchen. And it was in the beginning it was okay, because 2004 the cost of running a restaurant was very, very less. The rent was very low. Gradually it increased. So I don't know today's scenario, it would be a difficult thing for me if I really think about starting a restaurant. So 2004 the timing was good, I think. Probably everything was, it was quite easy for me to run the day to day expenses and all those things.
So as the rent increased, was that one of the reasons why you decided to buy your own, place in Alsur?
The idea was actually yes, because when we started the restaurant, the rental that I was paying was about 15 to 17,000 rupees, 17,000 precisely.
Okay.
To start with. It has gone up to more than a lakh now, so it's quite expensive, and every year it goes on increasing. So finally I thought if it goes like this, it would be difficult for me to absorb this additional cost. And moreover, what is happening is that dining out, it's decreasing already. But I thought, okay, maybe I'll have my own place so that I don't have to worry about this major chunk of paying rent every month. So that is why I decided to have my own place. So that's the whole idea.
And you decided to keep the old outlet running as well?
The initial idea was not that, to keep the old restaurant running. Initial idea was to actually close it down and move to the new place. But when we started the new outlet, we thought that for first few 3 or 4 months in the new outlet the business was less, and we had to keep the old one running because to get the revenue going. And gradually in the 6 months the business started picking up in the new place, and old one was not suffering badly. So we decided to continue both the outlets. So it's going on now, both the places at this
right.
moment.
So now that you have two places, what is some of the most popular dishes that the customers like?
See, our thing is we have got 4 types of flavors in fish curries. One is coconut based, one is less coconut based, one is without coconut based, and one is Amurti curry, which is a spicy curry with a mix of coconut as well as less coconut, but on a spicier side.
Okay.
The fastest moving thing is the one with the coconut base, because that is the very Mangalorean curry, which goes with most of the type of fishes, except for sardine and mackerel. Sardine and mackerel, you need a little spicy curry, so that moves first. So these are the two signature dishes. And when it comes to chicken, we have got chicken rose curry, which is a very authentic Catholic cuisine that is fast selling, I would
okay.
say. So that is called, that is the fastest moving and item in our menu.
Right. So speaking about the signature dishes, when you go to the market in the mornings, you sometimes see rare or unique kinds of fish, right?
Correct.
Which I'm assuming would be part of your special menu for the day.
Tell us
a little bit about some of these exotic fishes that you.
Right. When you go to any seafood restaurants, the main items that are there, about 8 type of seafood, I would say. One is pomfret, one is carne, one is sea fish and mackerel fish, and you have crab and clams and squid and prawn. These are the 8 items you'll find in any seafood restaurants. But if you look at the variety that is available, one is the shankara fish, which is quite popular in Kerala. One is curry mean, which is quite popular in Kerala. One is the dadiyare fish, in Konkani word I am using, it's called the croaker fish. And there is rich gourd, there is shatka fish, and the lepo, that is the sole fish. All this fish is only available on a given day. And this we cannot put it on a regular menu, mainly because if it's available or not, we do not know. That is why what we have is a day special menu. And when I get this catch for that particular day, I put it on the day's menu. And people
okay.
know, customers know that they first go and see what is available on a day's menu. And they for sure know that these are the unique kind of things which you get only in the market, where they don't get mostly in the outside restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why that's why the customers first focus on today's menu and they select that kind of fish.
Right. So what I'm getting is that there are around 4 USPs or unique things that Mangalore Pearl actually offers. The first and foremost being the price, which is slightly
right.
more affordable.
Right.
Then the actual taste, the authentic Mangalore Catholic
exactly.
cuisine. Then the third would be the special menu.
Right.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The special menu that you have. And the fourth would be just the fact that, people can come in with their families and
exactly.
pretty much enjoy your food at any point of time.
Right.
So what are some of the popular times? Do people come in for lunch? Do they come in for dinners? How does it work?
No, it's mainly lunch. And on a Saturday and Sunday, if you see this young crowd, which has moved their base from Mangalore to Bangalore to look out for jobs and all those things, you find all this young crowd coming on a Saturday afternoon and Sunday afternoon from all over Bangalore. You take from as end as Bannerghatta Road and JP Nagar, from this side Whitefield, people are coming into our restaurant.
Okay.
Coming to our restaurant. Mainly because they find that, you know, these are the kind of dishes they miss from their home away. This is basically a home away from home for them, actually. So it's like a, you know, homemade kind of feeling that they get when they dine in our restaurant.
And Steven, now that Swiggy, Zomato and all are becoming popular, food delivery is becoming very popular. How has that affected your business? Has it increased some of the orders for some particular dishes, or, you know, have you seen some dishes take a hit?
Actually, the trend is changing now. Dining out is slowly fading away, I feel. Because 30% of business comes from Swiggy now. Actually,
okay.
If you see the home delivery models, I mean the apps. Now, the thing is that the investment that goes into this dine-in thing slowly is going to hit badly. Because people do not want to go out. One, traffic goes, rains, matches, World Cup and all those things. And moreover, people are stressed out. They want to just relax at home. And when they go out, you know, when they go to a pub and come back, you know, this traffic, I mean, the police problem catching them, you know, on drinks and all those things. And all this is added up for people to just sit back, relax at home and order from their apps. So dining is out is slowly, you know, I feel it's hitting badly the restaurant business.
Is it so? Considering, you know, dining out slowly fading, what are some of the future plans? Do you want to move to a slightly more, you know, ordering in approach?
Actually, if you see, if you consider, once you establish a brand, because tying up with the delivery apps also is a difficult thing unless they know you well,
okay.
Unless the brand is really there in the market or not. Otherwise, it's a chance that they are taking. So once you build a brand, now I can easily set up a kitchen and say, tie up with the delivery apps and say that Mangalore brand is there and these are the dishes that are, I mean, whatever is available in our dining. And with this concept, what is happening is that most of our investment in the dining place, the crockery, you consider the furniture, the lightings, interiors and all those things, you are saving on all these things. Moreover, you are saving on a lot of stuff. You need only about 4 or 5 members. You are saving in a lot of water. You don't need to, you know, wash the dishes and everything. All this you need, the kind of water that you need is only to prepare the items and the dishes. And everything is packed. So,
okay.
You know, in a packaged thing. So, you're saving on a lot of investment, actually, if you see. And you're saving on a lot of input costs, on a daily cost. So, I think once you build a brand, it's easy for somebody to move in for a kitchen concept wherein you only you tie up with the delivery apps.
Okay, so does this mean that you are currently not looking at opening another outlet?
It's a risky thing. It's a risky thing to think about that. But given Mangalore Pearl's popularity, still people who want to give a dining experience to their guests and all those things, we, because of the plus points that I talked about, like going out to the market and making all these special fish available on our menu and also giving out on a very reasonable price, I would say. If I open another outlet also, there are still takers. There will be still takers. The only thing is that in the evening, crowd is less. You can have maybe in the afternoon, because if you put it up in a, if you set up the outlet in a office environment, possibly you will be sure to get a, you know, working crowd. But if you put it up in a residential area, possibly you may not get as much business as you would get on a regular day, but on a weekend you can be a rest issue, business will be there for sure.
Okay, so right now you're sticking with the 2 outlets, but you're not closing
the
door, saying that
at this moment I'm not
okay.
Thinking of a third outlet, no, not at this moment.
Okay, and in terms of dishes, is there anything new that you're planning to introduce, or maybe trying to retire some of the not so well performed?
No, the thing is that, see, when it comes to dishes, ours is, you know, 4 flavors of curries which go well with any of the type of fishes that we are sourcing out,
okay.
Sourcing in. So there is no way that we are thinking about, you know, closing down on any or taking the dishes out of the menu at all. They are going to be there for sure. But probably, definitely, we will have new dishes. But when we have new dishes, we will not have them on a regular menu. Because if we prepare today, we can't use it for tomorrow. Maybe we will prepare a few. We already have some dishes which are available only on a regular basis. Four or five different kind of chicken preparations, like in chicken spinach, chicken green curry, chicken puli munchi. All these types we do not have on a regular menu. We prepare them on a daily basis. So and so date only this is available.
Okay.
So what happens is that we will, there is no way that we will take it out of the menu totally. They are going to be there, but more and more dishes definitely will be adding it to our menu for sure. Now the thing is that, see, more and more people are health conscious and, you know, the oil fry and all those things. So the idea is to go in for continental kind of preparation where mm-hmm. you just steam the fish and, you know, provide with the vegetables and all those things. So that's the idea that I'm thinking of adding new dishes to our menu. Yeah.
Great. I'm sure all of your patrons would be looking forward to that.
Yeah.
So thank you, Stephen. This has been wonderful. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.
If you're looking for some of the best seafood in Bangalore, make sure you head to Mangalore Pearl. This has been SMB Stories MSME Week, presented by Google and powered by Dell Small Business. Thank you for watching.